for the shift linkage, we had to get the geometry right. And unfortunately, this is different for 6R80 and 10R80. As you'll see in the picture, the shift levers for 6R80 and 10R80 have a different hole in the center. And they also need to be a different length or ratio because the degrees per detent is different. But this general procedure would apply to both, and it also applies to just about any transmission swap. But I'll show you what we did. We had the factory 2018 F-150 lever that was on the transmission when we got it. It had a stud on it for a later model style cable, which we ground off and punched out, leaving a 5/16 inch or 8 millimeter hole there. We drilled another 8 millimeter hole in the lever, and we made this extension lever, which basically has a slotted hole so we can adjust the lever length, and we can adjust the angle too slightly. And we also have a half inch hole in that has a chamfer to allow us to put the factory nylon shifter grommet in there. And we used a shifter stud with the grommet, which is actually used on a Fox Body and SN95 Mustang for its shifter cable attachment. And it replaces the original Crown Vic extension lever with the stud on it. So that's worked out quite well. And of course that bumps, this is 3/16 inch stock, so it bumps the attachment point of the cable out by 3/16 of an inch. So we also needed to relocate the shifter cable. So we used another piece of 3/16 inch steel to do that and allow us to move the cable bracket around, and it maintains the proper geometry because it bumps up, everything's bumped out 3/16 of an inch, and there's plenty of clearance in the tunnel for that, thankfully. So we essentially put a nut on here on the stud and put it right in the center of the adjustment range. For starters, we set the lever up where we thought it needed to be. We'd done some preliminary testing before we put the transmission in the car, and it looked like it just needed to be slightly longer, so we set it at the shortest additional length. And then we bolted on this bracket, this 3/16 inch flat plate, which essentially spaces the bracket out. And we positioned the bracket until the geometry was right. We essentially lined it up in one of the ranges in part, and then adjusted the angle so that the shift cable is as straight as possible and not bending. And ideally in the middle of the quadrant range, right around neutral or drive, depending on how many positions you have. This transmission only has 5 because it's PRNDS for sport. And a 6R80 has 7 positions, PRND 3-2-1 or however you want to assign them. And a 4R70W has 6. So there's a wide variety, but generally as a rule of thumb with cable linkage, right in one of those middle positions, you want to be about perpendicular here. I think it's currently in sport mode right now, the lowest position. But if you move it to drive, it's very close to perpendicular. We didn't want any binding or anything in this. We adjusted all that to get the proper geometry. And what we did to make it easier to shoot the video and set this up, we're converting this car to a floor shift. So we have a floor shift console that we're able to set up, and it has a very long cable, which is very convenient. So we have the console over there and we can run through each position. This is the range sensor from the 10R80. As we mentioned, the detents, there's actually a leaf spring with a roller that rides inside these grooves, and each one of these is a position. This is park, reverse, neutral, drive, and then the sport or S position. And you'll notice that park to reverse is the biggest one. And that's pretty typical. And it's also the highest hump or little mountain that it has to cross over, because people really don't want their car going from park to reverse unless it's intentional. So most transmissions will have a much larger detent between P and R than the others, and you can usually see that on floor shifters and the indicators of transmissions. And pretty much every automatic transmission works like this. It has some sort of detent in it. For comparison, this is a GM 8090 range sensor, and you can see it's pretty much the same thing. Park, reverse, neutral, drive, 2-1. It actually has six positions. And it's scaled up a little bit because it's further out from the center line, so the notches are all larger, but pretty much the same concept. And for our 70W and just about every transmission works the same way, regardless of who made it or how. So that's in a nutshell. And just as an aside, that's where the linkage rod goes to the parking mechanism to give you park. On the 10R80, actually, there is no manual valve. So when you move the lever, all you're doing is moving these detents and changing what the sensor reads. And there's a magnet, basically Hall effect switches inside there and a magnet here. And as you turn the sensor, which actually comes apart, it changes which Hall switches are made with the magnetism. And it has two pulse width modulated outputs that the controller reads, and they're complementary. So one goes up in duty cycle as you go through the gears, and the other one goes down. So that's an error check. Since there is no manual valve, it's safety critical. So there have to be two outputs. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is to this sensor. So the only thing the lever does is turn this sensor, work the detents, and work the park linkage. Other than that, the shift lever doesn't do anything. So essentially, you've got detents in the transmission, as you saw with the position sensors from the 8090 and the 10R80. And then the shifter doesn't have detents, it has gates. Gates are what require you to push the button in, or in a column shift, pull the shifter towards you to move from one position to another. And you want to make sure that the detents and the gates are properly aligned. And if they're not, then you might have to adjust the cable or change the ratio of the linkage, in other words, the lever length. If they are properly aligned in one position but not another, then the lever length is probably the issue. So essentially what you want to do is go through each position. Of course, we're in park right now. Let go of the handle or the button, and it should already be in the detent without having to push it, or in the gate. So you get a reverse, let go of the lever, and if you wiggle the lever, it shouldn't go pop. It actually pops into the gate after you push it. After you let it go, it's not adjusted properly. So you push in, go to neutral, let go, wiggle the lever, it should be in the gate, and it shouldn't go click. So you do that for every single position. Let go, and it doesn't click. And then sport. That's how you know that the linkage ratio is correct and the shifter is properly adjusted. You put it in drive, per se, let go of the button, and then push it, and it goes click. Like, for instance, if you let go like this, and then you push it, and it does that, then it's not right. So in other words, if you put it in neutral, let go of the button, and push it, and it clicks. So if when you let go of the button or the lever, it's locked into position in the gate, it doesn't need to be nudged. If it automatically finds the right middle position, then the linkage is right. And you want to check every position. And if some positions are right and others aren't, then you need to change the length of the lever and get the ratio correct. So that in a nutshell is the main thing about shift linkage design. You really want to have the gates and the detents matched up. And a lot of times it's trial and error unless you're a whiz with geometry. So that's probably the most important thing. As you'll see now, the shifter's in park, which is all the way back when the lever's on top, of course. Fully clockwise on most transmissions is park. So we're in the park position. And what we're going to do now, we used vice grips, of course, to temporarily attach the bracket to the base there, and we've temporarily got a bolt in here to hold this. And we'll either put a second bolt in there, an Allen head, so we have clearance, or we will weld these together to permanently, to make that position permanent. And we'll take the base off, the cable bracket off with the vise grips, and then drill the holes where necessary and tap them so everything will be ready to go. Now, what I also need to mention is this yellow bracket, which is a factory Ford bracket, but not from the Crown Vic, and not from a 10R80. So the 10R80 cable uses a different attachment system, and the bracket's molded plastic and is not compatible with the Panther cable. We used a 6R80 column shift cable from like a 2012 F-150 transmission. I think the Explorer transmissions also use the same bracket, if I'm not mistaken. This bracket was pretty close to what we needed geometry-wise, and it had the same hole pattern in it, which is a pretty standard thing for Ford cable brackets. However, being the linkage is a little bit longer here, and the angle's a little bit different, we couldn't bolt it right on the transmission, hence the adapter plate. We've carefully removed the shift linkage and the plate without disturbing the vise grips so that we could get everything on the bench and get the holes drilled and tapped in our plate. You can see underneath how we constructed the plate, and these are the two holes that line up with the transmission. So we'll drill a hole there and put a bolt through there. And then for the other hole, we'll drill and tap a hole in the 3/16 plate with an 8x125mm tap. So we can put the other bolt in there, and then of course we've got the bolt here, which the bracket, the 6R80 bracket, doesn't reach. So then we're going to clearance the bracket a little bit up in here just to keep it off the insulator. It lines the floorboard of the car so it won't chew it up. And of course, since there's no bolt there, that shouldn't be a problem. Just a slight clearancing of that. And here's our shift link lever with the cable attached, as you can see, mid-range of the adjustment. Our temporary bolt and our other hole. And then there's the nylon grommet, which gets pressed in, and the linkage stud, which lets the cable attach. We'll probably make a plate that's threaded for two bolts and put two Allen head bolts through here to tie this up, and then clean everything up and paint it and make it look good by the time we're done, and get rid of the yellow paint, which is actually a factory Ford thing. All right, we've got the shift linkage finalized now. As you can see, we used two 8mm bolts to attach it to the lever, and the length worked out well. And we've got our bracket up here done and painted, and everything's attached, and it's all ready to go. It looks almost factory, so that's pretty good. We're very happy with how that turned out.